not a source of an electron, it nothing but it transport energy to the device. Let us draw a simple circuit with a battery and a resistor. So this is a battery which has a potential V, then positive and negative terminal, and it has been connected to a resistor R. So I'm going to take a 4 points in the small circuit. I'm going to name this is A, and this is B, and this point is C and D. So I current has been flowing through this terminal. Now we are going to assume that a small amount of positive charge DQ, I'm going to say very small amount of charge is DQ, passes to the battery from the point A to B. And then it passes to the resistor from the point C to D, then again it reaches a point at B. Right? When the charge is passing from the point A to B, what is happening is it gains the potential energy. Right? We are going to write this equation. Potential energy DQ is given by the equation what? V into DQ. So here, when a charge passes from the point A to B, it gains the potential energy, and at the same time, it loses its chemical potential energy at the same rate. Right? So this gain of potential energy, when it passes from the point C to D, it gets lost over due to the collision of atoms in the resistor, and it reaches the point A. So this process will continuously take place until the battery has been connected to this electrical network. So this helps us to calculate the rate at which the electric energy is delivered or electric energy is lost in an electrical circuit. We are calling this as what? Electric power. Now we'll define electric power. What is electric power? Electric power is defined as the rate at which the electric potential energy is delivered. Now we are going to derive it. So we are going to represent the electric power as the symbol of what? P. P is nothing but is what? Electric potential energy or power delivered to a network. P is equal to. What is the formula? So it is dU divided by dt. So what is dU here? It is dDQ. It is dDQ divided by what? dt. We know that rate of change of charge by current is given by what? Charge by time is given by current. Therefore, dI. P is equal to what? dI. So we arrived at the famous equations of power. Power is equal to what? VI. P is the power delivered and V is the potential difference across a connector and I is the current which flows through that. Right? So there is a unit of power will be given in terms of watt. So 1 watt hour. 1 watt hour will be given in terms of what? 1 joules per second. So 1 watt will be equal to what? 1 joules per second. Are you able to get it? So this is called as power. Electric power. Right? So commercially speaking, if I take a buy a bulb, what do you do if I buy a bulb or any electrical appliances, I can able to see the voltage rated in the device. So I'm going to take, if I'm going to buy a 5 volt bulb or 9 volt bulb, what will happen? So it will be rated. So what that value represents to us? If I buy a bulb, right? So I can say 5 volt bulb, they'll say 220 volt. Or 9 volt bulb, it will be say 220 volt. So this represents the power and this is voltage. What this represents? It is simply represents the AC RMS value. So our AC RMS voltage. So I can say that the voltage drop across the bulb is greater than this rated value, the bulb will fuse. Right? So if I supply a current, the voltage drop across that bulb is greater than this value, then the bulb will fuse. Now we are going to write a different forms of power relationship, right? So we are already studying what is the famous power equations. Now we are derived P is equal to VI. We know Ohm's law is equal to what? V is equal to I. I can substitute V. Therefore the power will become to be what? I square R. Or otherwise, instead of V, if I supply the value for I, V will be equal to what? V square by R. So these are the different notations in which what power can be expressed. Power can be expressed. From these two equations, I can say that so power is directly proportional to square of a current. If a current is double, power will be increased by 4 times. If a voltage is double, power will be increased by what? 4 times. Can I able to get this? Now we are moving for what? Electric energy. What is electric energy? I can say that electric energy given to a device is nothing but it's a product of what? Power and a time taken. So I can say that energy is equal to what? Power into total time period or time period of the device which is on, right? So power will be represented in terms of watt and time will be represented in terms of second. Therefore, energy will be represented in terms of what? Joule. Practically speaking, the electric energy will be represented by another unit called kilo, 1 kilowatt hour. What is 1 kilowatt hour? 1 kilowatt hour, nothing but it is 1 unit of electrical energy. It is 1 unit of electrical energy. Now we want to represent this in terms of joule. So how can I represent 1 kilo? Kilo stands for what? 10 power 3. Then it becomes becomes only 1000. So it becomes only 1000 watt high. So R has to be changed in terms of what? Second. So second is what? So it will 1000 watt into 1 hour equal to how much second? It is 3600 second. You can multiply this, that is if you have 5 power second, right? 36 into 10 power 5, or I can write this 3.6 into 10 power 6, right, in terms of joule. So therefore, I can write 1 kilowatt hour can be written as 3.6 into 10 power 6 joule, or 36 into 10 power 5 joule. Right, so we have clearly studied about what electric power and electric energy. What is electric power? It is a rate of doing a work. What is electric energy? It is a capacity to do the work, right? Is that here power will be represented in terms of a unit watt and energy will be represented in terms of a joule. Right? We are going to do a problem related to that. This is a very interesting problem. Example 2.15. So they are given a bar, two bars, one is of 60 volt and another one is what? So one bar is 60 volt. So this is a 60 watt bulb and this is a 30 watt bulb which has been connected to a potential of V unit. So they are asking us three questions regarding it. So when this is connected in parallel, they are asking which bulb will glow brighter. Which bulb glow will what? Which glow bulb will glow brighter? Then B, next one. Which bulb is having a high resistance? Which is having what? High resistance. Then third one, they are asking. When it is connected in series, when these two things have been connected in series, which bulb will glow brighter? Can you understand the questions? They have given a diagram like that. So here, the bulb, two bulbs are connected in parallel with the voltage. One bulb having a power of 60 watt and another is having a power of what? 30 watt. So when in this condition, which bulb will be glow brighter? Second, they are asking which bulb will have a high resistance. Third, they are asking when these two bulbs are connected in series, one after another, which bulb will be glow brighter, right? We'll prove it. So now we'll go for the first one. So we know the equation. What is the equation we know? Now only divide. So P is equal to V. So we already studied that when anything is connected in the parallel, voltage will remain the same. Therefore, here the voltage remains the same from the second, right? Power is directly proportional to what? Therefore, I can say that the which is having more power will draw more number of current and it will glow brighter. Which is having more power? 60 watt bulb will have a more power. Therefore, it takes more amount of current and it will glow brighter. Therefore, the first answer is what? 60 watt bulb will glow brighter. Right? Can you understand this? Then second. What is the second one they are asking? Which bulb will have a high resistance? Then what is the relationship we know? We know that P is equal to V squared by R. Here again P is remains the same. Therefore from this equation I can write P is proportional to 1 by R. Or R is proportional to 1 by P. So which is having more power? It will have a less resistance. So which is having more power? 60 watt bulb has a less more power. Therefore it has a low resistance. They are asking for high resistance. Therefore I can say that 30 volt bulb will have what? High resistance. 30 volt bulb will have what? High resistance. Can you understand? Then, now we go for the third question. What is the third question? When it is connected in series, which bulb will glow brighter? I will grab this. Right. When it is connected in series, means voltage will vary, current will remain the same. Therefore, I will take the equation V is proportional to what? R. V is proportional to R. Current, because current remains the same. Therefore, I can say is that which bulb is having more resistance or high resistance, voltage drop will be what? More. Therefore, which bulb is having more resistance? We proved it. 30 volt bulb has a more resistance. Therefore, 30 volt bulb will have more voltage drop. Therefore, it glows brighter. So, here 30 volt bulb will glow brighter. 30 volt bulb will what? Glow brighter than that of what? That 60 volt bulb. So from this problem, we can easily able to observe that. So it doesn't mean 60 volt or 30 volt the power rating. Only it represents the bulb whether it is connected in series or parallel. If I take a parallel connection, 60 volt bulb is glowing brighter. If I take a series connection, 30 volt bulb is glowing brighter. So So it is clearly inferred that what is that? The rating doesn't represent the bulb which glow brighter. It represents only the connection. Whether it is connected in series or parallel, it represents the bulb which glow brighter. Right? Is that clear?
Right.
Now we'll do the last sum, which I'll give you as a homework, but I will narrate that problem to you. Right? You do the similar way, you have to do the sum, right? So example, you can do the sum, example 2.16. That I have given 2 bulbs. So one bulb is having 20 volt, having 220 volt. Another bulb is having 100 watt with 220 volt. And they have given 440 volt. Right? They are asking us to find which bulb will glow brighter, which bulb will be obfuse. So we can find what? Either thing, which bulb will glow brighter, or I can find what? Which bulb will fuse, right? So for that, first we have to find the value of voltage drop. We know our term that the voltage drop of the battery or voltage drop across the bulb is greater than the voltage rating. The bulb will fuse. So we have to find the voltage drop at each bulb. So on this bulb, what is the voltage drop? And under one bulb, what is the voltage drop? We have to find. So for that, we have to find the resistance. Then we know the formula. R is equal to what? V square by T. V is equal to, from this formula, you have to find the value of what? R1 and R2. Then you have to find the value of what? R total. Because we want to find it is connected in series. Series means which will remain the same. I, to find I value, we have to find what? R total. So we know that V is equal to IR. I is equal to what? V divided by R total. So we have find current, we have find the value of current, and we know the resistance. So from this, V1 can be found. V1 is equal to what? I into R1. V2 is equal to what? I into R2. So it is up to that, we can easily able to find the value of V1 and V2. So we can easily able to find the voltage drop at the voltage first bulb and second bulb. You have to check with the rated value. If that is greater than the rated value, you have to say that bulb will fuse. Is it clear to understand? So right, you do it. If there is any issues, we will discuss that in the next video. Right.